Hola a todos and welcome to a new Spanish lesson with me, Sebas. Today, we'll continue with the videos from the series of Spoken Language and we will learn the uses of the verb tener. If you haven't seen my previous videos from the series verbs, you could check the video in the link up there so you can catch it up. As this is a lesson for students from the level A1, we will just use the conjugation from the present simple from the indicative mode. Dicho esto, empecemos. The main use from the verb tener is to express possession. In this case, it's the exact translation from the verb to have. Ejemplo, tengo dos perros. I have two dogs. Tengo dos perros. I have two dogs. Another use which is literally translated from the verb to have is when we want to express obligation. Ejemplo, tengo que hacer la tarea. I have to do the homework. Tengo que hacer la tarea. I have to do the homework. The following use is also translated literally from the verb to have and is when we want to express physical characteristics. Ejemplo, la chica tiene cabello largo y rubio. The girl has long and blonde hair. When we want to express that we suffer from a disease, we can also use the verb tener. Ejemplo, vosotros tenéis fiebre. Ustedes tienen hepatitis. You got fever. You got hepatitis. Vosotros tenéis fiebre. Ustedes tienen hepatitis. You've got fever. You've got hepatitis. Tener is also used when you want to express your age. Ejemplo, Claudia tiene 20 años. Claudia is 20 years old. Claudia tiene 20 años. Claudia is 20 years old. You will see that, like in the last example, the verb tener sometimes replaces the verb to be. Another one is we want to express hunger and thirst. Ejemplo, tenemos hambre y sed. Queremos pizza y jugo de naranja. We are hungry and thirsty. We want pizza and orange juice. We also use the verb tener when we want to express our weather perception. Ejemplo, quiero mi casaca. Tengo mucho frío. I want my jacket. I'm so cold. Quiero mi casaca. Tengo mucho frío. I want my jacket. I'm so cold. You will notice that for the cases that tener replaces the verb to be, you could add the adjectives mucho or poco, which means a lot or a little. Another example is tengo un poco de calor. I'm a little hot. Tengo un poco de calor. I'm a little hot. Another use is when we want to express that we're sleepy. Ejemplo, qué día tan largo. Tengo mucho sueño. What a long day. I'm very sleepy. Qué día tan largo. Tengo mucho sueño. What a long day. I'm very sleepy. Tener might also be used when you want to express that you're right. Ejemplo, Ricardo siempre tiene la razón. Ricardo is always right. Ricardo siempre tiene la razón. Ricardo is always right. This one is used in a very formal context when you want to express a place where an event takes place. Ejemplo, la conferencia tiene lugar en el palacio. The conference takes place in the palace. La conferencia tiene lugar en el palacio. The conference takes place in the palace. Tener might also be used to express that you're lucky. Ejemplo, Mario y José ganaron la lotería. Tienen mucha suerte. Mario and José won the lottery. They are so lucky. Mario y José ganaron la lotería. Tienen mucha suerte. Mario and José won the lottery. They are so lucky. Another use of tener is when you want to express that something is someone's fault. Ejemplo, Julio tiene la culpa. It's Julio's fault. Julio tiene la culpa. It's Julio's fault. Finally, tener is also used to express many mental situations. We will see different examples. Carlos me tiene envidia. Carlos is envious about me. Carlos me tiene envidia. Carlos is envious about me. Mi novia es posesiva. Siempre me tiene celos. My girlfriend is possessive. She's always jealous about me. Mi novia es posesiva. Siempre me tiene celos. My girlfriend is possessive. She's always jealous about me. Gerardo es mi amigo. Le tengo confianza. Gerardo is my friend. I trust him. Gerardo es mi amigo. Le tengo confianza. Gerardo is my friend. I trust him. Tengo ganas de hacer deporte. I feel like doing sports. Tengo ganas de hacer deporte. I feel like doing sports. Está muy oscuro. Tengo mucho miedo. It's so dark. I'm very scared. Está muy oscuro. Tengo mucho miedo. It's so dark. I'm very scared. Te tengo mucho cariño. I really appreciate you. Te tengo mucho cariño. I really appreciate you. Los chicos le tienen mucho respeto a mi padre. The guys respect a lot my father. Los chicos le tienen mucho respeto a mi padre. The guys respect a lot my father. Los ladrones tienen vergüenza cuando son atrapados. The robbers are embarrassed when they're caught. Los ladrones tienen vergüenza cuando son atrapados. The robbers are embarrassed when they're caught. Well, I guess that there's a lot of information for today, but believe me, there are some other uses from the verb tener. Feel free to put in the comments below if you remember another use from the verb tener. Remember that this is a community, so everybody can collaborate. And don't worry if you don't learn yet all the uses from the verb tener. This is something that we have to learn as long as we keep studying. If you have any question, opinion, or recommendation, just leave a comment below. And if you like this video, thumb up and subscribe. Soy Sebas y hasta la próxima.